अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। वेलकम टू योर साइंस क्लास। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द नीड्स ऑफ फूड एंड ऑल्सो द सोर्सेज ऑफ फूड, द फूड दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड द फूड दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम एनिमल्स। नाउ टुडे we will discuss what animals eat and from where does this food comes. You know all animals are heterotrophs and plants are autotrophs, because plants are capable of making their own food, but animal depends on plants and other living beings for their food. So animals are called heterotrophs. You have seen some grass eating animals, some flesh eating animals, some animals which eat only dead animals. So on the basis of feeding habits, animal can be classified as herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, decomposers and scavengers. Now we shall discuss each of them separately. First is herbivores. Herbivores are the grass eating or the plant eating animal, and they have many adaptations for this, like their front teeth are broad, they have hooves for which they can cover long distance in search of grasslands, and many more things. Example of herbivores are cow, goat, rabbits, sheep, deer, etc. Then the next category is of carnivores. Carnivores are flesh eating animals, and they have sharp canines to tear the flesh. They have jaws and they have claws also for tearing the food, and many other adaptations for capturing their food, which is not covered in this topic. Example of carnivores are tiger, lion and eagles, etc. Then next type of animals are omnivores. Omnivores are those animals which eat both plants and animals, like we human beings, or bear, or crows, rats and cockroaches. They eat flesh also and they eat grass or plants also. So they are called omnivores. Then there is a category of animals which eat flesh of only dead and decaying animals. These category of animals are called as scavengers. They are called scavengers because they help in cleaning the atmosphere, cleaning the soil, because they eat the flesh of dead and decaying animals. Then there is a category of microorganism which feed on dead plants and animals and decompose them. You know, when a plant or animal die, its body get mixed in the soil. Then in the soil, the microorganisms like bacteria are present. They decomposes the body of dead animal or plant and mix them into soil, so the soil fertility is increased. So these scavengers or decomposers are very useful to us. Scavengers help in cleaning the soil, and the decomposers help in cleaning the soil, as well as they increases the fertility of the soil also. Now we shall discuss food chain. What is food chain? Food chain is defined as a series of organisms linked together by the process of eating or being eaten for food. You know that in this whole universe, only plants are capable of making their food. Plants make their food in presence of sunlight. All green plants make their food. And green plants have which pigment by which they can make their food? They have chlorophyll. and this chlorophyll traps the solar energy and from the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and water of the from the which they suck from the root. Plant, green plants or the leaves make the food of the plant, and the food is called glucose, and oxygen is released during this process. This glucose is stored in the plant. When this green plant is eaten by an herbivore, then the energy is transferred from plant to that herbivore. Suppose a plant is eaten by a goat or a deer, then this goat or deer will be eaten by a lion or a tiger. Then the energy from this herbivore goes to the carnivores. Then when this animal die, this carnivore, its body get mixed in the soil and it is decomposed by microorganism. Then what happened? Then it is the body is mixed in the soil and increases the soil fertility, by which another plant takes nutrition. So in this way, each link of the food chain is connected to another. So a food chain is defined as a series of organisms which is linked together by the process of eating or by being eaten. Every food chain begins with the plants. Why it begins with the plant? Because plants are autotrophs. They are capable of making their food. In this picture you can see a plant is eaten by a cat, and this cat is or rat is eaten by a snake, and the snake is eaten by an eagle, and then eagle dies and the fungi and this mushroom is shown, that is a fungi which decomposes the body in the soil, and again the nutrients are mixed in the soil from the which the plants take nutrition. So there are many examples of food chain in your book also. So you can see what is a food chain. Now next topic, which is very important, that is food problem. You have seen in during this pandemic that many people are dying less of pandemic and more of starvation. In the last year, when the lockdown was forced in the country, many laborers which were residing in metro cities were forced to come back to their villages, and there they had faced the problem of starvation and they had died in between. So food problem is a very important issue in our country. Many people of our country do not get enough food to eat because of poverty or shortage of food, and there are many people who waste food also. See children, food should not be waste in any ways. Whenever you go to a party or a marriage ceremony or any other ceremony, you take a lot of amount of food in your plate and then you leave the whole plate in the dustbin. That is very bad. Food should never be waste, because there are many people in this world who are dying because of hunger. And food problems can be sought out by growing more crops and using modern methods of farming and storing the food grains properly, and the leftover food should also be conveyed to the needy. It must not be thrown in the dustbin, and food should not be waste in any ways. So this is whole chapter. This completes your chapter. Go through the lectures, and in the next period we shall discuss the exercises and question answers. Okay.